PI. I'm going to develop the function isEven in R in a test-driven way. To do that, I need to write a test that fails. So for example, isEven of 2 should not give me an error message. So I expect silent. I expect if I call isEven with 2 that there's no error message, which is what expect silent test. Expect silent is part of the test that package. It's a very commonly used testing package. And if I run this code, it says that it can't find the function. Well, that's very reasonable, so let's write it. So isEven is a function. And that's about it. So let's see if we pass the test. Unused argument, all right, so we need to use that argument. Great, we fixed it. Next step would be that it actually would do something. So for example, I expect if I put in a 2, 2 is an even number, that it should return true. So that test should fail, it does. So let's just do it like this. This is the laziest way to make all tests pass. Next step is we need to break it again. Well, for example, the number 3 is not even. So I predict this test will fail. It will fail. It says, yeah, but the function says it is an even number. So now I need to do my first kind of programming. So I know that the number's even if I take the modulo of 2. That's division, the remainder of a division by 2, if that equals 0. So let's see if that works. This still works, this still works, this still works. That's great. So let's see if this also works for negative numbers. That works. So I can remove the test, because it didn't break the code. Minus 3 also works. Also, 0 is an even number. Let's see if that works. Also works. That's great. So you may consider it's already done, but it's not. For example, I expect an error message, a clear error message. If I put in the word nonsense, then it will give me an error message. The error message must be something like X must be a number. So that would be a good error message. It does not. It gives me a different error message, which no beginner would understand. So we need to add this to the function. So let's do that. With is numeric, you can check if it's a number. So if X is not numeric, then it should give me an error message. So we're going to stop with this error message. I'm just going to copy it so I don't make any typos. And let's see if all the tests still work. That works great. So next thing is a bit more of a philosophical, like a design question. So let's say I'm going to call isEven on 2 numbers. Let's say 1 and 2. Then you could argue that this call to isEven should return a false and a true. So it should return 2 values, because 1 is not even, 2 is, so it should return a false and a true. But you could also argue against this, because, well, if I tell to you, is the numbers 1 and 2 even, that does not make sense in English. So in that case, you could write a function called are even, which tells me if the numbers 1 and 2 are even, which may return only one value, or true, false. But so this is a philosophy, like more design issue. I like to follow the English language. So if a user puts in 2 numbers, then I would expect the error message that X must be 1 number. So let's see what happens. It does not throw an error yet. So we also need to add that. So if the length of x differs from 1, if the length of x differs from 1, then there must should be x must be one number. Let's see if everything still works. Tuck, 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 tuck. Everything works. This is beautiful. So there are some special cases in R that you can check. Null is one of them. But that doesn't break the code, so that works. And A is another one of them. Works. Infinite. So apparently infinite has an unknown, it's unknown if it's an even value. So let's add an error message here, because well, it can't determine if infinite is even or not. So if let's make it an error message. X must be a non-infinite number. So so we broke the code here, so that's great. That does not throw an error yet, but it should be. So we're going to add another test. We know that the error message must be X must be a non-infinite number. And there's a function called isInfinite. isInfinite. Then this should be, so let's see if it works. So let's load the whole function, run my old tests, all work. Bam, also works. Let's try minus infinity, also works. So that is great. So now I see no points of improvement to this function. So this function is production ready. So you can put it in your R packages. So maybe there is a bug still in this function, but then someone will write the test for you that fails, you agree with him or her, and then you can improve this function. But for now, for me, I can sleep reasonably well because I think I did the best I could. So here I showed you how to develop the function isEven in a test-driven development way using R only in a script. And I wish you a very good day. Bye.